it seemed like there was some bad feelings between you and Matt Brown, possibly entirely one-sided. Was that resolved by the fight? Do you feel like you've earned his respect?
Yeah, I mean, that was just him working with my old coaches, man, telling them, one, I'm probably a slow starter, and two, I'm an emotional fighter, so probably get in my head and try and go out there and get me to fight angry. So I got him to hug me in the third round. It was all good.
So that's another knockout victory for you at welterweight. I know you've bounced back and forth between welterweight and 155. Where do you feel you stand now in welterweight with another ranked win?
I feel good, man. Fat and healthy and living the good life at 170. So I feel good up there. Should be easy enough for me to cut to 170 in a few weeks to make a Denver card, I think. So it'll be all right.
Cowboy, congratulations on the win. Your striking once again looked even better than the fight before and the fight before that. How much of that do you owe to Brandon Gibson and the work he's done with you?
Oh, definitely, man. Brandon and I have been working together. You know, I a lot of credit to what's going on there. My head movement, though, didn't look too good, did it? Damn, I took a lot of punches, I think, a lot of unanswered ones. But, hey, you got to dig deep sometimes. That's what I love the most about the sport is when you're up against a fence taking the hard punches and you got deep all the way down and be like, yeah, man, fuck it, let's go.
And obviously you like to keep active and fight as much as possible. You know, you're on sort of your own cowboy schedule, so to speak. How many times do you want to fight next year as far as, I know Denver is sort of the first stop, but after that, have you kind of looked at next year, how many times you want to fight?
Oh, man, as many as I can. That's what I love, you know. A lot of people like to take time off. I don't know why I don't. I enjoy.
Hey, Cowboy, great. Congratulations on your win today. If there is an opponent out there that you would like to fight, who would that opponent be? Does it matter? Or?
No, it doesn't matter at all. I don't care. I really don't. I mean, if I had to pick one, I'd want Damian Maia because he's on the way to the title fight. But if I had to hurry up and choose someone for Denver, whoever they want to give me, you know, that doesn't matter to me at all. So staying busy, staying fun, and that's what I love.
And the fans here, they're outside just, you know, cheering for you. How do you like the fans in Toronto here?
It's awesome, man. I'm 3-0 in Canada now. They're finally letting me back up in this beautiful country. So it's good. Maybe I can come up here without the UFC, do some fishing, some hunting. We'll see.
Cowboy, congrats. Did the eye bother you at all in the fight?
Nah, he didn't really hit me in the eye. He hit me in the neck a couple times, but eye was good. I don't even think it started bleeding, but it really wasn't a concern, you know. It healed up nicely and ready to go.
Was the fight tougher than you expected it to be?
Way tougher. You hit a lot harder and it was a lot more durable than I expected him to be.
And you mentioned that you want to come back to Canada without the UFC. Can you only come to Canada if you're fighting?
Yeah, because I have to get a temporary visa to get in. Well, I didn't this time. It's the first time that they kind of just were like, oh, yeah, you're here with the UFC. I handed my passport and let me through, so maybe I'm on like a rehabilitation program, So maybe I'm rehabilitated, I don't know.
And in the back, I know you said you wanted to fight in Denver, and there's Masvidal and other people who would like to fight you. Usually these things with you happen quickly. Is there anything that you can tell us about Denver?
I know nothing, so hopefully I get back here and they have a contract waiting for me. If it's Masvidal, fucking A. If it's someone else, even better, let's go.
And finally, just to wrap up the week for you, can you tell us about your lunch with Dana White? How did it go?
It went very good. It wasn't a lunch. He just pulled me aside after the media scrum, and we talked for about 15 or 20 minutes, and he's a happy man, and I'm a happy man. So just talking about what I wanted to, like I discussed with you, and, you know, what he expected out of me, and it went very well.
Do you feel like he was receptive to what you were saying?
1,000% receptive, yes, definitely.
Do you feel like you're in a good place with him now again?
I was always in a good place. It's like it reminds me when you get in trouble with your dad and they don't ground you. They just tell you how disappointed they are in you, which is even worse. So that's kind of what he did to me. And he's just like, you know, you let me down. Not so much let him down, but it was just kind of a slap to his face. You know, I guess I should have let him know what I was getting involved in. It is what it is, but we're on the up and up now.